Hey everybody, this is Brianna Rutter, and in this hair tutorial, I am going to teach you how to do a lace wig installation step-by-step for beginners. The hair I am wearing is a glueless full lace wig from Luffy. My Luffy hair wig is textured Peruvian wavy, and it has a pre-plucked hairline with baby hairs. The hair color is natural, and it has bleached knots, and it's 130% density for a very natural and realistic appearance. The length of my Luffy Peruvian Wavy Glueless Full Lace Wig is 22 inches. If you want to check out this hair, links are in my description to get this beautiful wig. So now I'm going to show you a very quick unboxing of my Luffy wig that I received from Luffy. And now I'm just showing you the inside of the wig. And as you can tell, it has a mesh lace in the middle so that it can allow for an easy adjustment to fit pretty much any head shape, as well as three clips for attachment and a band in the back to help you to secure your wig to your head. Now this is how the curls look fresh out the box, and of course when you wash the wig it will look a little better. And this is the clip that you can use for styling your hair that they sent me, as well as a wig band just in case I needed it for my wig, and wig caps to help me to attach the wig to my head for a natural looking scalp. Now this is the baby hairs on the wig. It's anywhere from about 3 to 4 inches long, and if it's too long for you, of course you can trim them off. This is how the wig looks at the very back and then at the very front hairline area. Now as you can tell, the lace is transparent, so that way it can blend with pretty much any skin tone. And this is how the texture of the wig looks. Now that my wig is on my mannequin head, I'm going to style it up with just a little bit of hair gel. I honestly did not have to do anything. The hairline was perfectly pre-plucked. It was very realistic and natural to the eyes. So if you want a wig that doesn't require much customization, this would be a wig that I would highly suggest. So I'm just using an edge brush to brush hair gel onto my hairline. And I like to use Eco Styler hair gel at the level 10 when I'm actually molding down the hairline of my wig. And this is how it looks right after I apply just a little bit of hair gel. Now at this point, I'm going to show you my braids. They are extremely simple, and to make sure that my hair doesn't get frizzy underneath my wig, I made sure to add a little bit of braiding hair to each braid. Now I'm going to slowly trim off the lace at the very back, saving about a quarter inch of space away from the hairline lace at the back of the wig. At the front of the wig, I like to leave a little extra lace, and I'll show you why. So this is how it looks so far. Now I'm just positioning the wig on my head, and I'm pulling the back of the wig to make sure that it's exactly where I want it to be before I begin removing the lace at the front of the wig. So you always want to always triple check, double check the positioning of your wig before you cut off lace and before you mold it down, so that way you have your perfect fit. And this is how it looks so far, right before I begin removing the lace. So I'm just going to use some regular scissors, and I'm going to go around the hairline, making sure to save a little bit of lace near the edges of my hair where my actual sideburn area is, because my sideburns go a little lower, and I like to make sure to have extra lace to cover that up so that it literally has no leave out once I put my wig on. So I'm making sure to go about a little bit over a quarter inch away from the hairline itself, so that way I can fully cut off more lace if I need to. So I don't cut off too much before I apply it. And this is how it looks so far. I never cut a straight line because I notice I get my most natural appearance when I have a lot of curves at the beginning of the lace. When I put it on my head, it makes the lace disappear for me. So now with the wig back on my head, I then trim off any excess lace that was a little too long, so that way I can have a perfect fit. So after cleaning it up, I went ahead and I adjusted the strap that's at the back of the wig, just moving over one notch of space, so that way my wig will have a firm fit. And when I did that, I didn't have to use the clips at all. So now I'm putting a very light colored cap on my head, so that way I can make my scalp look more realistic while I'm wearing my wig. Because the actual wig has transparent lace, I suggest that you actually mold your hair down with a cap, so that way your hairline or your scalp will actually look more realistic. Now I'm using Got to Be Glue hair gel that I'm putting on my hairline. I like to put it pretty much right on my hairs at the edge of my hairline, and being that my hairline is pretty close to my forehead, I try not to go too far back. So now I'm going to use some hairspray, and I'm going to spray that right on top. This is Got to Be Glue hairspray that I'm spraying on top of Got to Be Glue hair gel. I never suggest that you use hair glue because it can be pretty damaging on your hairline, and it's pretty tough to remove. Now, there are some women that it works for, but for most women, I suggest, especially if you're a beginner, that you use these products. Now, I'm just going to lightly blow dry my hair to make sure that it's fully dry on the light setting right before I begin cutting off the excess cap. So now I also like to use my comb to smooth it onto my sideburn area because that area for me tends to lift a lot. I always have a little bit of hair peeking out from my cap. Now, if you're a beginner, don't worry if you don't get it perfect your first time around. Even though I do so many creative and cool styles, sometimes I have to continue to practice a lot off camera until I pull off an effect that I like and that I feel comfortable teaching you guys. So for some of these styles that I do, I'm actually learning as I go as well, right along with you. But as soon as I find hacks and tricks that work for me, I then like to show you in my tutorials how to do it to achieve a beautiful look in the comfort of your own home. So you're just gonna further clean it up with scissors and also close the head of your scissors to smooth under your cap to make sure that you can cut off excess to have a very custom line to your nude wig cap. Now this is how it looks right before I begin applying my wig. At this point you could add powder to your hair, but I normally like to stick with the color of the cap. So now I'm just going to put a little bit more hair gel on my hairline as well as a little bit more hairspray. So that way when I actually put the wig on, it can stick immediately to my hairline. So just use a little bit of product at a time and just take your time to smooth it in to make sure that you're not having too much product running down your face or your forehead. So that way you have a very clean looking finish. And I'm not gonna mold it back, I just leave it exactly how you see it here. And then I put the wig on my head, making sure it's adjusted in the back first before I push down the hairline. So as I'm pushing down the hairline, I'm making sure that I'm actually grabbing as much hair as I can in my hands, so that way I'm not ripping the lace, because the lace is very, very thin for a natural and realistic appearance. I like to use the end of my rat tail comb to further press the lace into the hair gel, so that way it can blow dry very effectively. Now, I tend to have some hair gel always get on the hairline, so I just comb that out once the hairline is dry, and then I use hairspray to touch up any areas that has a little bit of lift. Now, to get the little bit of flakes off of my hairline that came from the Got to Be Glue, I like to use just my regular Eco Styler hair gel to smooth it out while also sculpting the edges of the hair. So when I like to wear lace wigs, I don't really like to have baby hairs, meaning like short pieces that kind of swoop over, because I believe when I look at my hairline, it looks pretty close. Like, I don't think I have as much forehead space to have too much baby hairs. So I barely like to swoop it out past the hairline, and I like to keep it pushed back mostly. So the baby hairs that are on the wig, I do leave it, but I just gel it back so that I can create this look that you see here. So now I'm just showing you how the front looks on both sides, and I'm showing you that the back is not molded yet. And for sure, as I always do, I like to show you all the details. So I'm just clipping the back of my wig. So after clipping the wig hairs down, you're then going to adjust your cap, and then you're going to adjust the back of your wig to make sure it's placed exactly where you want it. So now I'm just demonstrating with my fingers where you're going to be putting your hair gel. I like to first outline where the gel needs to be, and then I like to push it into my hairline right before I begin spraying it with my Got to Be Glue hair spray. Now, I normally like to use the Got to Be Glue spray and Got to Be Glue gel because I've tried other hair gels and it just doesn't give the same results. So if there's any other hair gels, not glue, just hair gels that you like to use, let me know down in the comment section so that way I can experiment with it and show you how to mold down your wig using those products. So make sure it's tacky to touch when you're blow drying, meaning that when you touch it, your fingers should feel very sticky and wet, but it should be sticky enough so that you can stick down the back of your wig. So if you like these tips, let me know in the comments. Now you're just going to make sure to press it into your hairline, making sure to smooth it so that the gel gets soaked into the lace. Also, if you've watched this far, I have been having secret conversations in my comment section that I want you to be a part of. All you have to do is leave your comment on my pinned comment, which is the very first comment at the top of my comment section. I want to know your thoughts, so join in on our discussion and let me know what you think. Make sure to reply to someone else's comment too, so that we can keep the discussion going. Now I'm just using a spray bottle that has nothing but water in it, and I'm spraying through my hair so that way I can help the wavy texture come to life. And now after I've done spraying my hair and I allow it to dry as a little time has passed, I'm now going to show you how the scalp of the lace looks in just a second after I finish brushing the water through my hair. So I like to use a little bit of heat protectant, being that I'm actually going to flat iron my hair in just a little bit. When I'm blow drying hair with any type of curl pattern, I like to do this scrunching technique so that way the ends of the hair do not look straight. So now I'm just parting throughout my wig to show you how realistic the scalp looks. Because this is transparent lace, it allows for whatever color cap underneath to show through perfectly. So most scalps tend to be a little lighter than our skin tone or our face color. So make sure to go a little lighter with your cap, or you can go the same color with your skin tone, whatever you prefer. And this is how beautiful and natural the hairline looks. Now I'm just quickly flat ironing my hair so that I can show you how this Peruvian wavy texture of the Luffy wig looks once it's been flat ironed. And I'm gonna do a spin around really quick to show you how gorgeous and realistic this hair looks. When it's straightened, it kind of reminds me of a yaki texture. I wanna thank y'all for watching my full lace wig install tutorial. Give me a thumbs up and comment what you wanna see next. And if you want to get this beautiful Luffy wig, the links is in the description. Click the bell for notifications so that you don't miss any more of my tutorials. And I'll check y'all out next time. Bye-bye.